According to standard evolutionary explanation, it took from 26,000 to 2 million years to produce that layer of limestone, very slowly. But according to the creation concept, using the work of Professor M.E. Clark, as the waters of the worldwide flood were building up, they had not yet covered the globe, but were building up, the effect of the moon bringing those waters into resonance and with its gravitational effect would cause a tidal bulge on both sides of the globe simultaneously. As the waters were ascending on a global scale, we have evidence around all three of those arches. In the state of Texas, the dinosaur tracks are around those arches. So those arches were apparently refuge areas. So as the tidal bulge brought in a new layer of material and then swept on over, then those who had been fortunate enough to be in refuge could come back and forage for food. So we're finding their tracks on layer after layer. To show that this is not an accumulation of hundreds of thousands or millions of years, and to show that it's essentially an overnight epoch. Here we have a worm burrow. That is the refuse left as the worm burrowed through the material. And all of it was pliable enough for him to burrow in. This is made of calcium carbonate. That's what you make concrete of. M.E. Clark is the specialist showing that in a matter of days, this would have cured. There would have been no way for him to burrow through concrete. But he was burrowing overnight, and he's not burrowing horizontally. Doyle, the importance of your discovery is that it's vertical. All of that was pliable. So this turns out to be quite significant in demonstrating that this is an overnight epoch. Yesterday I mentioned the clam burrows. If a clam was under the surface, that lithified so fast he couldn't work out, but if he was on the surface, there's a burrow mark. The clam has a little foot and he burrows like that. And even that burrow mark cured so fast that it preserved. There's another one right here. Now, if that required another one over there, if that required long periods of time, that would level out and smooth out. But it cured so fast, it's like a cat or a dog walking across freshly laid concrete, and it preserves.
Clams and other bivalve shellfish, called polysipods, are found in great abundance in fresh and salt water. At the beach, where waves wash in, sand and shellfish are deposited on the beach surface. Shellfish immediately begin to burrow down into the wet sand. If you pick up handfuls of wet sand after a big wave, you can sometimes feel small shellfish burrowing down, even to the point of trying to squeeze between your fingers. What happens when a clam dies? A clam is mostly two durable shells, a connecting ligament that also acts as a spring to open the shell halves, a foot that it can extend outside the shell for burrowing, and a powerful muscle to close the shell halves. At death, this muscle relaxes and the shell halves spring open. There's usually a hungry animal close by to eat the shellfish, leaving the shell halves connected and lying open. This is what we see in large numbers on beaches and creek banks. Even if the shellfish dies in thick mud and is somehow held closed, normal sand and soil movement soon separates the shell halves. However, in many deposits of limestone, vast numbers of fossil polysipods are found tightly closed. This can only happen during a catastrophic event that buries the shellfish in sediment that hardens quickly enough to prevent the shells from separating. More evidence of rapid sediment hardening is explained by a member of the dig team.
Hello, my name is Harry Jackson, and it's the Wednesday, the 2nd of July. We're busily in the process of removing a layer of limestone. Here we are removing it actually layer by layer, and as we're splitting the layers apart, this chunk came apart and it has evidence of clams inside the layer, where the clams have burrowed into this what is rock now, but at the time was probably mud. And they buried into it, burrowed into it, just like they would into the bottom of the sea. Unfortunately, this stuff hardened up so fast, they couldn't get back out. So we know that it's fossilized clams, because we have this, we took this little edge off of the piece of shell right here. And if you look at it in the sunlight, you can see the crystalline form that's in the replaced shell. So we know that these are fossilized. And this piece goes right approximately here, the other way around. It was stuck right there as we pulled it out of the ground.